So where's Susan? I know she's out there. She's a part of this team as much of all of us. As you know, she's gone on several of these with us. So she's coming. Jeff, if you could start the video, please. We're going to play a short video here, and then we're going to have a bit of a conversation about what we learned from this trip. Close a wall, the last board down, we bless this house.
It's a good idea.
And all the occupants in it.
There we go. You put the date on
this one. If the Lord builds the house, nobody can tear it down. The Lord builds the house.
So I hope you all enjoyed that video. A little bit about ASP. We've been going now for a few years, and the theme of ASP is to make homes warmer, safer, and drier. The home that we were given this year, we had two ASP teams. One team was working inside, that was our team, and there was a second team working outside that was doing the siding on the house. And you saw them at that in the video there. One of the things too, and just to explain it, whenever we go on a mission trip, and it's been kind of our tradition to do this, is at the very end, we'll come, the youth actually pick the verse from the Bible, and we'll write that on the back of that drywall. And then we all sign it. So it's kind of cool.
And the hosts.
Yeah. And the hosts. And the hosts. The hosts sign it as well. And the hosts participate in picking that verse as well. So that's just something that we do. We find that to be very rewarding for the family. And it does. It gives them something to think about when we're away. Just real quick about what we did. Inside the house, when we got there, the floor needed to be repaired before we could put down the flooring. And before we put down the flooring, we had to fix a wall that was having some drywall issues from prior, which created a bigger problem, but we won't go there. And then we had another bedroom that we had to finish all the drywalling in. And then we were taking the paneling apart in the hallway. And as you saw, we actually got to the point where we were starting to move down the hallway with the drywall. And then we left and we turned it over to the next team who's coming behind us. ASP only runs for 6 weeks. So there's a lot to do when you start doing this kind of construction work over a 6 week period. And each week there's another contribution to the progression of that job. So with that, I'm gonna turn it over to John, who's gonna start some introductions. You wanna start the introductions?
Yeah. First, do we have the PowerPoint? Thank you. So, so teams from, So teams from all over the country participate, and we come to Central Appalachia to work on these homes. And but before we go, you saw the bookshelf over here. Before we go, we participate in some skills and safety training. So this team all got together before we went and we taught how to use saws and hammers and measuring tapes and knives.
And everyone came home with all their fingers and toes intact.
Mostly intact, yes. And so we did that. So the bookshelf was our way of practicing and teaching our safety and our skills training. So everybody got comfortable using saws before we left. And here's our team. Okay, let's get started. Let's introduce ourselves. So I'm John Scheibel. That's Mike that's already talked. But tell us how, give us your names and how many mission trips, your age and your mission, how many mission trips you've been on. Kathy? Hey.
Okay, I'm Pastor Kathy. I'm 58. Thank you very much. I've been on many, many mission trips through the years, but this is my first one for ASP.
I'm Melanie, I'm 19, and this was my first year with ASP.
Christian, or Chris, I'm 16, this is my second year at ASP.
I'm Miriam, I'm 15, this is my second trip on ASP.
I'm Rachel, I'm 13, and this is my first trip on ASP.
I'm Lily, I'm 14, and this is my first trip on ASP.
I'm Susan, and I'm 78, so I didn't travel with them, but I did try to support them for the last many years.
How many trips have you been on?
Oh, I've been on two, but I go to camp, too. So I've been camp three times and two times for ASP. We used to do this every other year. Now they did it 2 years in a row.
And I'm Mike, by the way, and I'm 60-something.
So for anyone under 50, let's give me one word to describe the trip. Maybe.
Unbelievable was my word.
I'm going to go with eye-opening, which counts as one word because there's a hyphen.
I would go with unfathomable.
I would go with amazing, you know, like, it's amazing the work we did and, you know, our opportunity to be down there.
I would go with interesting.
So, Rachel, this is your first year. Why did you decide to participate this year?
It seemed interesting, and I had never done something like this before, obviously. So I just kind of wanted to see what it was, and yeah.
Okay. Lily, why did you decide to do this?
I decided to do this not only because I would be with my best friend, Miriam, but my parents and I also have a trade in Valpo, and we do heating and air for a living, so indoor work and outdoor work is kind of what we do every day. So it was interesting to me to put that skill set that I have into working for God.
Nice. So Miriam and Chris, you went last year. Why did you kind of pushed Mike and the rest of us to go again? Tell us why.
It's just so much fun and so unbelievably rewarding to see how much work you can get done in a week and how amazingly grateful the hosts are to us for coming down, for helping out. And it's also a great way to get to know each other and meet new people, make new friends. It's just overall an amazing experience.
I don't know. I'm gonna basically say what she said. It's like, it's awesome to be there with all you guys and, you know, help family out that we didn't know before and create a bond with them that we wouldn't have otherwise.
Okay, so somebody up here, tell us about the theme this year. Rachel, or Miriam? Miriam, go ahead.
Okay, since they're all looking at me. The theme this year was love strong. Love your neighbor as yourself, and just the phrase this year was, he answered, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Which is very much a test of that in going out into this field where you don't know these people and these people are less fortunate. And so it's always a test of love with all your heart, with all your mind, and all your strength. And that's very much what we do on this trip.
So, Rachel, follow up with what Miriam was saying and tell us about how your faith played into your decision to go on the trip this year.
Well, I do feel like I didn't really know what to expect, but I anticipated a little bit more on the work side. And I don't think I had really thought through like all the relationships with your homeowners and your team and God that you make. And there were definitely a lot of those. So I do feel like my strength, my bond with God has grown.
Okay. And Lily, you already talked just a little bit about your decision. Tell us a little bit more about how your faith played into your decision to participate.
So my faith, in the Bible, it talks a lot about patience and believing in your faith, and that came into play a lot with what I did there, because when something wouldn't fit right, like we had a lot of trouble with the drywall, when it wouldn't just fit right when you wanted it to, I got really frustrated and I needed to have patience with it because I knew that some areas were a little uneven with the floor. And it took time for me to understand that I needed to have patience with the faith that this would fit into the wall and that I wouldn't lose my mind in the process.
Chris, you're up. Tell us about how your faith played into your decision to go.
Okay. I feel like last year kind of like started getting like the ball rolling and stuff, and I think that this year really helped me like connect more. Like I said this when we were there, but last year went in like a blur and I wasn't able to like think about everything and like suck it all in, stop and smell the roses, I guess. But this year I was able to do a lot more of that, and I think it made me a lot more grateful for the work that we were doing and the ability to be there.
Pastor Kathy, would you tell us a little bit about the host family?
So we had Mary, I'm not sure how old she was. She was kind of up there in age, but she was the owner of the house. Her son Richard lived with her, and Mary has cancer, and she has a lot of other health issues on top of it, but every day we would go see her, and it reminded me of going to my grandma's house when I was a kid. She would, every day we'd show up, she would welcome each and every one of us, and the minute I saw her, she'd say, "I was looking for you. I was hoping you would be here." And I'm like, "Well, I'm supposed to be here," but she was just so kind and loving, and she would come out and she would check on us at all times. And, you know, Richard, he would tell us stories, which we're not going to share, but he would tell us stories. And they were just so entertaining. And Richard even tried to help us a few times, and Mary would try and do what she could. And we'd sit and have lunch, and they'd come out and talk with us for a while. And they were just amazing people to be there with. There was even a day where I think it was Miriam and Lily were outside, and they were with the outside crew, and Richard decided to turn on this loud music. We thought it was one of our youth, and we're like getting ready to yell at somebody. Here it was Richard, and they were outside dancing away, and the other team got down and they were dancing. We were inside working. But it was amazing because we did get to see a video later of them dancing, and they were just having a great time. But, I mean, this family, they were wonderful to be with and to share stories with, and just to let, I mean, I think they needed that. They needed to talk to other people instead of just one another. So it was great. They were a great host family.
So let's talk about some of the actual work we did on the home. Describe some of the work that you did. Maybe Chris, start.
So in one room, we had like... What? Oh. In the first room, we had like flooring that was... There's like a little square that wasn't there. And then there was this like subflooring, I think. So we had to like patch that up. And then we laid down Luan? That thing. We had to cut it, measure it. That's mainly what I did, and cut it with stuff with John and PC. And yeah, we put down vinyl flooring, and that was the other room. And there was another room that had like drywall we had to put up and move stuff around. We made a bed. That was probably the hardest thing of the trip, making the bed.
Who directed you in making the bed?
There were like six of us there. It was horrible.
Six making the bed.
Yeah.
So you got to remember the house, the people are living in the house, so the bed has to be covered every day. So we would cover it, and then we'd uncover it. So every day, he made the bed.
Miriam, talk about some of the work in the hallway.
We had the absolute pleasure of being able to very carefully take down the walls in the hallway, which was such a joy. And then we had, me and Lily, had the joy of being able to go out and carry
You know, you would think drywall, it's very skinny. You wouldn't think that it's all that heavy. It's very heavy. So when you carry it from place to place, and they're big, they're bulky, they're not easy to carry in any way. Like, you think you just carry them into the house. No. No. It's... Oh, yeah, and then we had to cut it. And then we tried to cut it 3 different times, but we couldn't quite get it correct. And then on the third time, Mike was like, you might shoot me for saying this, but it's still not right. And we spent probably a solid 10 minutes trying to get it inside alone every time that we did this, and then we had to take it back outside, and then we had to cut it again, and Lily almost had a moment. It was amazing.
Rachel, tell us about some of the work that you did with the floor.
Oh, got it. So we put down vinyl plank flooring, which the room was very helpful in the fact that it wouldn't let us just put full boards down. I don't know why that had to happen, but whatever. So we had to cut them. I got put in charge of cutting them. My hand did not like me by the end of the day because you're taking the little X-Acto knife and you're cutting it and you're making weird cuts to fit around a door frame or, you know, the last few cuts at the edge of the closet, you know, it's like different dimension on each side. So you have to make a not straight line. So that was probably the day that I sweat the most.
I will tell you, Rachel did a great job. I mean, everybody did a great job. Rachel did a great job with, I would throw out a measurement to her of like how long we needed a plank. And, you know,
I got very fast.
17 and 3/16. And it came back, and every time it was right on. So whoever taught her fractions, you know, thank you for that. She learned that and was really great. So, Lily, tell us about a new skill that you learned.
I wasn't very good at drywall when I got there. Mike has let me know that I'm a level 3 drywaller now, whatever that means. So I didn't really know how to drywall. I didn't know how to do corners to make sure you didn't have, you know, like gaps in your corners, because that's a little awkward. So Miriam and I tackled the Mary's bedroom, which was a bigger bedroom, and the bed was in the center of it. So you had to try and go around the bed all over and get the corners. And then the next day it wasn't dry, so you couldn't put the next coat of mud on it. And that was a little bit difficult. And it was just hot and humid, so the humid getting in, it was wetting the mud more than we needed it to. So that was interesting.
Chris, how about a new skill? Since you were one of our veterans, what did you learn new this year in terms of skills?
A new thing I learned, I guess, was using the little handheld saw. Last year, we only used the miter saw, so this year, John broke out the handheld one, and I was able to cut stuff.
Not my fingers. All of the long cuts on anything we did, Chris was in charge of. So, Mel, how about you? Any new skills?
I never like laid a floor down in a house, and also like hammer nails into like the boards. I never done that, and I only hammered my thumb about 3 times.
Well, that's pretty good for a whole week. That's a pretty good. Pretty good ratio. So, describe the most challenging part of your week. We'll start with Chris, and we'll work our way down.
Yay. The most challenging part of the week was probably the first day. I think when you get there, you expect it to like instantly start working and like just run right into it. But you have to like see what you're doing and say hi and like just like do normal stuff, I guess, but I didn't like think about it. I thought I'd get straight to work. I also cut my finger that day, so that sucked.
Good. Miriam?
I honestly would say that there was not anything particularly challenging other than dealing with Christian.
Ouch. That was not on the script. Next.
Well, I would say, I wasn't the one having to deal with this the most, but it was like our final piece of luan that we were putting down. Had to work around the closet, and there was a hole for a wire to come through as well. And the first time we laid it down, it fit perfectly. Almost perfectly. We had to make like some tiny, tiny little adjustment. We go to lay it down after we made that, it doesn't fit. And it keeps not fitting, and not fitting, and not fitting. We eventually realized the first time the cord had been under it, so it had bowed a little bit, so it was able to like just kind of snugly fit in. But I don't even know how many times we tried that, like 5 or 6 times?
It was an embarrassingly high number of times we did it wrong. And it was, but we got it right in the end.
Mm-hmm.
So, Lily, any challenges?
My challenge wasn't necessarily with the house. My challenge was getting up every morning because the day before had been pretty hard and every day was like 95 degrees outside. So in the mornings, the ASP team, the staff, they put a speaker right next to your door and they blast music. I mean, it's a new level of volume. And so they were playing the music, and then once the music stopped, you had to go outside for the devotional that day. And I nearly fell asleep one morning during the devotional because it was so tired. Such a tiring day.
Okay. So, all right, I want to get back to your faith again. So we all worked hard, 5 days with the family who were awesome people. But tell us kind of the takeaway of how you changed or how your faith changed evolved during the week.
This is such a hard one because my faith has been evolving all my life. I think this trip really helped me see, like I said earlier, my patience and how not everything's going to fit perfectly the first time. And you really have to, you know, find the little things that'll outweigh the bad of a situation. So.
Rachel?
I would say it kind of ties in my one word. Well, one word.
Remind us of your word.
Eye-opening. Because it really was a whole different experience than I think I was expecting, and there were definitely many God moments.
Share one.
Well, we actually talked about this one night, the night before we left the center, and I think I shared my God moment was Mary would come back and check on us a lot. And every time she would come back, like the joy and happiness in her eyes of like seeing what we were doing and seeing how nice it was going to look once it was all done. That was really nice to see. Like she was just so happy, and we're there to help them and to give them a warmer, safer, and drier place to live, and she seemed to really appreciate that, so, yeah.
I would say that I just loved everything, like just everything that I came in contact with, whether it was the sunset in the evenings, or it was the sunrise in the mornings, or it was animals that I saw, or I just loved everything. And there were just moments that you just wished that your eyes would just were just recording, like that you could just like get a replay of that one moment, and you're like, oh wow, that was a really nice moment. Like, and there were just some moments where you just I just think that those moments will always kind of hang with you. And I think it was just, there was just so much that I totally loved that I spent pretty much the entire week going from thing to thing that I totally loved and enjoyed and was unbelievably obsessed with.
Can you repeat the question?
Talk about how your faith grew or changed through the week.
Okay. I think at least other than last year, a lot of like the ways that I serve in my faith, I'm the Sunday school assistant, so it's like a lot of like on like not I guess on hands-on stuff, but like teaching and you know being someone that knows stuff over the kids. But now it's like I'm learning, and it's kind of like the roles were switched for me, and I enjoyed it at least.
Mel, can you jump in on this question too?
Yeah, so halfway through the week, there was another group that was at the center with us, and they brought in prayer shawls from their church, and they had already like been prayed over and everything. So we took two of them for our group and the group that was with us at the house and gave them to Mary and Richard. And as soon as we told Mary that they were prayed over, she just started crying, and she seemed very happy with, I mean, everything there, but especially the prayer shawls.
So I'd like Mike and Pastor Kathy to talk about this too, I mean, send the mic back now. Just about how, I mean, you both have been on lots of mission trips. How were you affected this time?
I've missed going on mission trips because I've gone almost every year and then COVID hit, and so I really miss going on mission trips. But this was a new experience, new group of people that we got to go with. My daughter was with me, and we've served other mission trips, but I think it's like Melly said that Mary was so grateful. And as we picked out, we asked her to pick out a Bible verse, and I looked at her Bible, and her Bible had no binding. It was a huge family Bible, and she's flipping through the pages, and I'm standing there with her so that the pages don't fall on the floor, but just seeing her faith and how she lived her faith. Here she is suffering from cancer. She's inviting strangers into her home every week. And she loved on each one of us. And my heart is so full because of her. So, yeah.
That's pretty well said. I think how it affects me and my faith is introducing the youth. And I just love, I have this great passion to see them grow, to see them go meet the family, really kind of engage. And it's not just the hands and the feet things, it's the relationships. And I will tell you this, when we left, every one of us were crying our eyes out, including me. And it, because of Mary, she was so grateful. And she was so, she herself was full of grace. She was just amazing. And she was saying to me, she's saying, hey, you know, you're going to be back here in 2 weeks, right? And, you know, you don't want to say no. And she was, we knew she was joking, but she kept saying, you're going to be back here in 2 weeks. So, to me, that's the fulfilling part of this, and it's God's will, and it's God's journey. And Miriam and Christian pushed us to go this year because we went 2 years in a row. And I said, man, this is going to be tough. And it was tough, but at the end of the day, it was so rewarding. And that's God's will. He pushes you, and you got to say, okay, we're going to go do this, and you do it. So, John, I want to hear your answer here, too.
Well, you know, I think just the thing that sticks out is just the fact that this is a trip in which we are really hands-on with people. I mean, we're teaching skills, we're learning new skills, we're making these great relationships, but we are very much hands-on meeting people and making a difference in their lives by working on their homes. It's a lot of the things that we do here, we are being the hands and feet of Jesus. It's just a really remarkable way to live that out in a way that we don't get to do here at home. So I have just a couple more things. I know we're kind of running late on time, but a couple really important things. Some thank yous to some folks who helped us out. I want to thank Pastor Kathy and Mel, who were kind of recruited at the last minute in the process, but they were really important and pivotal in getting us there. So a big thanks to them. Pastor Kevin and Kate Shiflett and a whole church staff who do a lot of work behind the scenes.
Yeah. Don't forget, Susan was signed up to go. And then at the last minute, something came up. She couldn't go. So it was her intention to go. That's why she's sitting up here with us today.
So we want to thank Deb Webling, Tammy Scheibel, who do so much of the work behind the scenes, and the stuff that nobody sees get done, it gets done because of them. We want to thank the missions committee, who they back us. Whenever we've got something missional, they're there behind us, and we appreciate that support. And we want to thank the congregation for your prayers and your financial support. It doesn't happen without that. So one real quick thing, Mike, if you want to talk about this connection.
So I don't know if you if you all remember, but last year we June and Paul, we worked on their house. We actually were installing a bathroom for them. That was a big job, and we did a handicapped walkway for them. We were driving past the exact location on our way to the new center, and we decided to stop just out of the blue. And June was so happy that we had stopped just to say hi and ask how she was doing. And they're continuing to have some difficulty. Paul in the picture up there, he has bladder cancer and it's progressed. But June, she's also had some health problems and actually had a car accident right before we were there. But just amazing people. These are the people we meet, and these are the people we minister with, or minister to. And it's just amazing when you can go back and revisit a family that you saw prior to. So thank you for that, by the way.
So yeah, just a reminder how, you know, when we're doing missions, that it's work with real people, and even when your time with them is done, their life and their circumstances are going on. So it was nice to kind of get back and check in with them. So final question, really quick, for the youth. What did you guys think of the decision to have lunch at the Waffle House on the way down?
Thumbs up, thumbs down.
All right. All right, thank you, everyone. Thanks for bearing with us.